morning to one and all present here. I'm Sushil Joshi and you're watching the Math Magic. In today's lecture, we're going to learn the chapter number 6 of class 4th maths, that is the junk seller. Here you see the topic which already mentioned here. This is the one of the most important part that we are using here, the junk seller. So what is mean by the word junk? Have you ever heard the spelling of junk and the meaning of junk? So look here, I will tell you. The first we will see it. What do you mean by a junk? Junk seller. A person who sells the junk. In Hindi, it is called as the kabadi wala. So based on this junk seller, this whole chapter is given to us. So look at this picture carefully. Here are the two pictures are given to us. The first one is, I will zoom it so you can easily verify. So what is given to us here? Look here, the first picture, you will see that Kiran Sumitra Kabadi ki dukan. Kabadi means junk. Kiran Sumitra, the junk shop. This is given to us. Here so many used tires are kept under some shed. Look here. So if you count 4 and 6 and near about 11 tires are there. And here in the second picture, the picture of that lady is given to us whose shop is there. This is the Kiran. This lady Kiran. This is Kiran. So we'll just see it, what is given to us in this chapter. First I will read it. So do you understand what is the base of this chapter? The base of this chapter is based on only two operations maximum, that is multiplication and division. How we can solve it? Look here. Have you ever met Kabadi Wali, a woman who sells junk? Just we see here, a woman who sells junk. And this is the meaning of this word Kabadi Wali, a woman who sells junk. This is a true story told by Kiran. This story is true story told by Kiran, who has a junk shop in Patna. Where is this junk shop situated? Patna. Note down it. Again we read it. I studied in a Hindi medium school. She studied in Hindi medium school in my village. My father wanted girls to study like boys. I love Hindi and science. Which two subjects she loved the most? Hindi and science. But I hated maths. Oh, this is the main thing given to us here. She hated maths. As we are studying maths, maths is not a popular subject among students. They feel very difficult when they solve the different types of the questions. Today, maths is the most useful for my work. But what she again told, maths is very useful for my work. I could never imagine this in school. So that's why she felt it very difficult when she solved the different types of the maths problem at her school age. School days. What about you? Do you also find maths difficult? So this is a question for you. Self, you have to recognize whether you find it difficult or not. If easy, then write here. Do you find maths difficult? So if easy, write here no. And if difficult, write here yes. So it is depend on you. What is the most difficult thing in your math book? So up to 6 we have studied the chapter 6, that is right from the first one is that is building with bricks. The second one is long and short. Third one is a trip to Bhopal. Fourth one is a tick tick tick, that is based on the clock. The fifth one is where to look from, and the sixth one is this chapter. So up to 6th chapter, what do you feel the most difficult thing? So I thought when I was teaching mathematics, the student they find it very difficult in solving few questions of tick 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 chapter. So right here, tick tick tick, and in tick tick tick, the conversion of hours into 24 hours. So right here, conversion of time. They find it most difficult while solving the different kinds of the problem. What do we think is the easiest lesson? Easiest lesson is pattern, that is building with brick. Pattern in building with brick. Bricks. So they find it very difficult because they love the pattern, they love drawing, they draw a beautiful pattern like this, so they find it very easy. When I was young, my father died in an accident, so my mother worked as a servant. Her mother worked as a servant in some houses. We had a difficult time. I had to leave school after class 8. So she left the school after class 8. I wanted to study more, but my mother got me married. She wanted to study more, but her mother got her married. That's why she is not able to study more after class 8. My husband's family live in a mud house. Her husband's family lived in mud house. The house made from mud. His two brothers and his sister did not go to school. He had a tea stall. Remember this. His two brothers and sisters also did not go to school, and they had a tea stall. Find out how much for a cup of tea. Now, few questions, general knowledge GK questions are given to us. Ask people and find out the cost of a cup of tea. Nowadays, a cup of tea at a tea stall, a simple tea stall, is rupees 10. So right here, rupees 10. At a hotel near about 30 rupees, rupees 30. So I write here 30. If a person who runs a tea stall earns rupees 30 in a day, how much he will earn in 10 days? Look here, whenever a question is given to us like one to many things, that means you have given the cost of one thing and you have to find out the cost of many things, that time do multiplication. What operation you have to use? Multiplication, whenever you have to find out the cost of many things from one thing. Look here, a day's cost is given to us. That means one day cost is given to us, and from that you have to find out the 10 days. So we do here multiplication, 30 into 10. It is very simple. First multiply by number, 3 into 1 is 3. Then put how many zeros are there? 1 0 and 1 0, 2 zeros. So put 2 zeros over 3. Like this, she will earn rupees 300. And in a month, so this is a month of August, there are 31 days. So I write here August, 31 days. So we multiply it by rupees 330 into 31. So 1 0 is a 0, 1 3 is a 3. I'll put over cross here. 3 0 is a 0 and 3 3 is a 9. Right here, plus sign 0 3 9. So right here, 930. Right here, 930. It will clear you. I write it in black pen. So I write here, in a month of August, She will earn rupees 930. Look here. How did you get the answer? So by this method, we will get the answer. I hope all of you understand this part. Now we move toward the next part. I thought of starting my own business. I thought I should open a bangle shop. She had an idea to open a bangle shop. Look here, here is given to us, or a tailor shop. But my uncle said that we could earn a lot by opening a junk shop. But what her uncle told to us? Her uncle told to her that she must open a junk shop because she can earn a lot of money by opening a junk shop. In 2001, my mother-in-law and I opened a junk shop. We took a loan of rupees 8,000 for a shop. Look here. Loan amount, write down, is equal to rupees 8,000. Remember this. Loan amount is rupees 8,000. Now we have one question given to us. Find out what is a loan. A loan means a thing, an amount which we borrowed from somewhere. A loan is an amount which we borrowed from somewhere, that is from the bank or from the loan vendors, some people who gave the loan. Have you ever heard someone taking a loan? Yes. Yes. For what? For education. Now some people, they take education loan, crop loan, that is the person for planting, and somewhere in villages they take the crop loans for purchasing new house or flat or house, for purchasing new house or flat, for purchasing land, and etc. For other purposes also, the people are taking loans. How much loan was taken? Suppose you want to purchase a flat or house, you nearly take a loan up to 20 to 30 lakh. I like write here 30 lakh. 3,000, 30,000, 3 lakh, and 30 lakh. So there are 6 zeros over 3. How much money was paid back? So if there is a 10% interest, near about double amount is to be paid. Suppose I write here 50 lakh. 3 zeros, 4 zeros, 5 zeros, 6 zeros over 5. So near about double amount we have to pay. If we take a loan, a huge amount of loan is taken by us, then we have to pay again a huge amount with respect to that loan. Hariya and Babu want to buy a hand cart for rupees 300. The two persons, look here, a question is given to us. Hariya and Babu, the two persons took a loan for hand cart. And loan amount is rupees 300. Loan amount is rupees 300. I have taken a loan. What the Hariya said to us, I have taken a loan of rupees 300 from a bank for 6 months. I will pay rupees 51 every month to the bank. Again, I read it. I have taken a loan of rupees 300 from a bank for 6 months. I will pay rupees 51 every month to the bank. So he took a loan of 300. Look here, I write here the answer. Loan amount for 6 months. What is the loan amount? Loan amount is 300 रुपीज, 300 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 6, सो व्हाट इज द लोन अमाउंट हियर? सॉरी, दिस इज नॉट गिवन टू अस. लोन अमाउंट इज गिवन टू अस इज रुपीज 300. ही पेड बैक रुपीज 51 फॉर 6 मंथ. देयरफॉर अमाउंट इज इक्वल टू रुपीज 51 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 6 इज इक्वल टू 6 1 6, 6 5 30. द अमाउंट इज रुपीज 306. द अमाउंट इज 306. सो हरिया पेड बैक इज इक्वल टू रुपीज 306. आई विल राइट इट इन शॉर्ट, रुपीज 306. बट लुक हियर, व्हाट द बाबू बाबू आई हैव टेकन लोन ऑफ रुपीज 300 फ्रॉम चुन्नी लाल. आफ्टर 6 मंथ आई विल पे बैक रुपीज 360. ही विल पे बैक रुपीज 360. लुक हियर, इफ आई माइनस इट, 360 माइनस 306, सो व्हाट वी गॉट हियर? लुक हियर, टेन माइनस हियर आई राइट हियर 5, 10 माइनस 6 इज 4, 5 माइनस 0 इज 5, एंड 3 माइनस 3 इज 0, सो 54 मोर रुपीज. लुक हियर, आई राइट हियर 54 मोर रुपीज पेड बाय बाबू. 54 मोर रुपीज पेड बाय बाबू, दिस यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर. लुक हियर, सी हियर केयरफुली, 54 मोर रुपीज. सो हु हैज टू पे बैक मोर, हरिया और बाबू? बाबू हैज पे पे बैक मोर, बाबू. सो स्टूडेंट, व्हाई दिस हैपन्स? बिकॉज हरिया टुक अ लोन फ्रॉम बैंक, बट बाबू टुक अ लोन फ्रॉम चुन्नी लाल, अ लोन वेंडर. सो व्हाट पर्टिकुलर थिंग वी ऑब्जर्व हियर? डू नॉट टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम लोन वेंडर्स. द पर्सन हु गिव्स गिव्स द लोन, डू नॉट टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम दैट पर्सन बिकॉज दे विल चार्ज यू मोर. ऑलवेज टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम नेशनलाइज बैंक वेर यू कैन ईजीली पे द सर्टन अमाउंट एट अ फिक्स इंटरेस्ट. दैट मीन्स द पे बैक अमाउंट इज फिक्स, द रेट इज फिक्स. दैट्स वाई इट इज ऑलवेज ईजी टू टेक अ लोन फ्रॉम बैंक, नॉट फ्रॉम द लोन वेंडर्स. People laugh and tease us about our work. They called it ganda kaam or dirty business. What she told here, the people laugh at her because she is working in a junk shop. They always call it as ganda kaam or dirty business, but I did not think so. I knew this idea would work. Now we have a pakka house with electricity. We have a fridge, a TV and a gas stove. My husband's brother, sister and also my daughter go to school. Because of this junk shop, she made a pakka house. Look here, two terms are given to us. In EVS also, you have observed the two terms, pakka and kaccha house. These two terms are already you have observed in EVS class. So the pakka house means the house made up of bricks, the steel iron rods, the cement, and the kaccha house is made from a mud. Look at this. The board is here. You can saw the board, electricity board. That means electricity is present in a house. वन टीवी कनेक्शन इज गिवन टू हियर, टीवी कनेक्शन इज देयर, सो मेनी बैग्स आर केप्ट हियर, सो हर हस्बैंड्स ब्रदर्स सिस्टर्स ऑल्सो गो टू स्कूल, फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन इजिली ऑब्जर्व. नाउ लुक हियर, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व द पिक्चर केयरफुली, सो मेनी बॉक्सेस आर केप्ट हियर, वन टू रिक्शाज आर देयर. लुक हियर, दिस इज वन रिक्शा एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड वन इज देयर. टू रिक्शाज आर देयर एंड I have 9 rickshaws of my own. I give the rickshaws on rent, each for rupees 20 a day. On Sundays, I do not take any money for them. That means 9 rickshaws are there. Look here. 9 rickshaws and 20 rupees a day. If you multiply it by 9 zeros are 0, 9 twos are 18. She got rupees 180 a day. She got rupees 180 a day. Rupees 180 per day. How much does Kiran earn in 9 rickshaws in a day? So here this is the answer, rupees 180 in a day. Per day means in a day. For one rickshaw she get 20 rupees per day. So for 9 rickshaws she will earn rupees 20 multiplied by 9. Just we observe here, 9 zeros are 0, 9 twos are 18, rupees 180. Right here, rupees 180. How did you do it? Hey, I will do like this. 9 times 2 is 18. This is also correct. 9 times 20 is 180. This is also correct. But I find it this easier. For 10 rickshaws, she will get rupees 20 into 10, 200. And for 9 rickshaws, she will get rupees 200 minus 20. For a cost of one rickshaw is to be subtracted from here. That is, cost of one rickshaw is rupees 20. That's why we subtract 200 minus 20 and we will get rupees 180. So in both ways, our calculation is same and we will get the same result in both the ways. Think of some other ways to do it. You can think of some other ways. Also, you can do it by different ways also. In a week, how much does a Kiran earn from one rickshaw? So, in a week, there are 7 days. So, I write here, in a week, there are 7 days. This is equal to 20 multiplied by 7. 7 zeros are 0, 7 twos are 14, so rupees 140 she will earn in 1 week. Now, few questions are given to us. Do it mentally and write the answer. So this is first one is very easy one. 6 twos are 2 is 12. 20 multiplied by 6. Do it here. 20 multiplied by 6. 6 zeros are 0, 6 twos are 12. So here answer is 120. Again look here. 2 multiplied by 60, 60 write first, then write 2, 2 zeros are 0, 2 6 are 12, again we got here 120, 42 multiplied by 3, write here 42 multiplied by 3, 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 126, write here 126, 4 multiplied by 80, 4 0, first multiply to 0, look here. Don't make a bigger multiplication. 4 zeros are 0 first. Then multiply 8 to 4. 4 8s are 32, right? 32. Similarly, same things we have to do here. 4 multiplied by 1 first. 4 1s are 4. Then 4 multiplied by 8. 4 8s are 32. Again, the same thing you have to do here. 9 multiplied by 5. 9 5 is 45, right here 5, carry 4, this carry is 4, then 9 2 is 18, plus 18 is equal to 22, so right here 22, 225. Now look here, the same thing you have to do here, 1 9 is 9, right here 9, 9 3 is then 9 3 are 27. So in this way, you can do the multiplication. No need to multiply like this by complete method. This is a very time consuming and tedious and long method. So do not use it. Now look here. What this ant told to us. 4 multiplied by 18, 4 more than 4 multiplied by 80. Am I right? Yes. She is right. So we turn towards the next topic. I have my own small junk shop. Look here. I buy junk from junk collectors. These two people are junk collector and this is a Kiran. They go from house to house and bring junk on hand cart. I then sell it at a big shop. Later she sold it at a big shop. How much to pay for this junk? Now look here, this is another example. The question is given to us. How much to pay for this junk shop? Kiran bought some junk from junk collectors. Look at the next page, the rate list, to see today's rate. Help Kiran to find out the cost of the junk. The cost of a junk is given to us. One question is given. 1 kg newspaper cost rupees 5. 1 kg newspaper cost rupees 5. 30 kg cost, 5 multiplied by 30 is equal to 150. It is okay. Look here. 30 multiplied by 5. 5 zero is a 0. Then 5 3 is a 15. Rupees first multiplied to this, then multiplied to 3. 5 zero is a 0 first and 5 3 is a 15. For 31 kg, so 31 multiplied by 5, first multiply by 5, 5 is a 5, then multiply to 3, 5 3 is a 15. So right here 155. In this way, you will find it. How much Kiran pay for 31 kg newspaper? So right here, rupees 155. Look here. This method is given to you. 31 multiplied by rupees 5. I hope all of you understand the first question.